cotton crop in especially in Punjab. Cotton productivity is influenced by too many aquatic and abiotic factors. It's a highly volatile crop and it's very much important crop, especially in southwest Punjab as far as diversification of agriculture is concerned. If we are able to sustain this crop in the state, it will be a marketable for the farmers, especially for the competing groundwater, irrigation water. So, let's go back. All we know that cotton is a highly sensitive crop. Many aquatic and water factors affect it. During the whole growing period of the crop, the attack of more than 1300 insect pests are there, especially in Punjab, about 10 to 15 insect pests are more serious on cotton crop. Its productivity always remains volatile over a period of time. Especially in the year 2015, there is a huge crop. The cotton crop, the history of the cotton crop is that after 1905 to 2002, the cotton crop is almost over in the state. And the area has gone as down as to 2.5 lakh hectares, around 7 lakh hectares in the state. That was because of methanol work. In 2002, there was an introduction of BT hybrids in Gujarat, and in 2005, the BT hybrids came into the state. So that was a new technology that reached the area under the crop. Then again, on the BT crop, there starts the attack of sucking pests, which is not meant for the sucking pests. In 2015, there was a heavy attack of whitefly on this cotton crop, and the productivity has gone as down as to 195 kg per hectare. So there's a big question before the scientists, before the university, that whether this crop will sustain in the state or not, whether the recommended technology is valid, whether the recommended technology is doing its job in the state. So in Department of Economics and Sociology, there's a regular feature of economic crop surveys, especially on cotton, wheat, paddy, wheat, and crops. We used to do the survey from the soil to the market effects, what the farmers there are doing, what the university is going to recommend. In this regular survey, we have pointed out what are the factors which are not followed by the farmers, which are the erosion gaps at the level of the farmers, which tend to fail this crop. Next. So we have conducted a 2-year comparative survey. These are the sample survey details. In all the Bhatinda district, we have 7 crops. We have selected about 28 villages. In 2015, that's a regular survey. That's not mostly from that survey. We have pointed out some, identified some constraints which are crucial for this cotton crop. So these are the 2-year surveys. Next. What are the constraints we have identified in these surveys? Especially if we, two things are important here. One is time of sowing and second, area under recommended BT hybrids, which is the basic, necessity for the crop success. When we are able to get the germination of the cotton, it means 50% crop is, we have able to get the 50% success of the crops. So for this germination, we have to sow the crop during the recommended period of time, which is mid-April to mid-May. So if we have a look on this table, towards the horizontal, on the last three figures, during 2015, in the fortnight of 16th to 30th of April, only 0.68% area was sown in 2015. On the first fortnight of May, 80% area is sown during that time, and you say that around about 80% area is late. So a massive campaign was organized during the 2016 when the crop failed in 2015. The Department of Agriculture and University, they have identified 500 scouts in around about 1,000 villages, and the constraints which we have identified, we have main focused on these constraints, and we are able to apply these recommended technologies in the field. So you can see during 2016, we are able to sow the crop during the recommended period of time from 0.68% to 36% area was shown during the second fortnight of April. And during the first fortnight of May, we have increased the area up to 60%. So during recommended period of time, if we say that we have able to delete the area from 20%, around about 18.85% to 3.4%. During 2016, only 3.45% area was laid shown. Almost 96.7% area was shown during the recommended period of time, which is the major factor responsible for the well germination of the crop. If the crop is good, germination is good, then almost 50% stress of the crop is assured. Second, on this horizontal side, the recommended BT hybrids. You see, in 2015 is 18% recommended BT hybrid, the area increased to 70%. It's a highly volatile factor. There's one factor around this. There are four varieties, especially Shriram 84, Shriram 85, RCS 713 and RCS 655. Around about 70% area is under these hybrids. So during 2015, university has not recommended these four hybrids. During 2016, university has recommended these four hybrids. So that's why the area increase is about 18 to 76%. Because those variety was all.
Dr. Mana, please sum up your paper within 5 minutes. We have time to.
Okay. So in the horizontal table, we are able to increase the area under recommended hybrids in 2016. Next. This is the balanced use of fertilizer. If we see the green figures under the nitrogen column, 14.5 to 60 kg nitrogen is a recommended dose. We are able to increase the recommended dose during 2016 in case of nitrogen, in case of phosphorus, in case of, especially in case of zinc. We are able to increase the recommended level of fertilizer crop. Next. This is very crucial potassium nitrate, which is recommended 3 to 4 sprays are recommended at the time of flowering. During 2015, 85% farmers, they are not using this spray. This is a soluble fertilizer coming in the package of 1 kg. We recommend 3 to 4 sprays. This is highly profitable for this crop. So in 2016, we are able to increase the number of sprays from 43 up to 43% from zero level. So we can say that in 2016 the balanced use of fertilizer has been assured. Next. This is the initiate the need based insecticide spray. This is the major factor which is going to contribute in the cost of production of cotton. This is the major factor which is going to spoil the crops when we are not using the recommended dose or recommended pesticide, and especially the superior quality of pesticide. That was very much popular in 2015. We have all known that in 2015, too many scandals of the state government ministers were also highlighted in the papers. So during 2016, the recommended the level of sprays, if we say up to 5, only during 2015, only 13% farmer used up to 5 sprays, while rest of the farmer they are using 4 number of sprays. By 2016, more than 80% farmer they have used up to 5 sprays. Next. This is the crop damage we have assessed. Up to 25%, say during 2015, more than 70% crop damage was on 75% of the farmers. Why? Whereas in 2016 it was only zero. So managing the need-based spray, managing the recommended time of sowing, managing the area under recommended BT fibers, we are able to minimize the crop damage. Next. So from this study we can conclude that if we are able to apply the recommended technology in the field in which we have applied during 2016 to 500 scouts and 1,000 trees, our productivity has grown to a reward production of from 195 kg length per hectare to 756 kg length per hectare. So if the farmers remain vigilant from the insect pest attack, monitor the field regularly, use especially if there is a complete control on the quality of the pesticide, we are able to save this problem. Thank you.
Next. No, the paper is open for discussion, please. Any question of the clarification?
So my main focus was whether this technology is working or
not. Okay. You have mentioned that this problem can be solved to below level. If it will go for your recommendation.
Yes.
Why your institution, this PAU and our Punjab Agriculture Department is not giving extension subsidy to the farmers?
Yeah, this is a very good question, sir. During the 2016, 800 crores or more funds were allotted by the central government. So it's a very good campaign that can be followed each year, and we are following the White Flight Act campaign each year. Start from the next month, we will start. But there is a lot of funds required, and especially the Department of Agriculture, which is their duty to control the quality of the pesticide. If we are able to control the quality of the pesticide and give a huge campaign for the farmers for the implemented level of technology adoption, then this crop can be seen.
Okay. I am coming from social sciences area.
Yes.
However, agriculture scientists clearly brought out that white fly attack is due to a movement and hot weather. That is due to the crop combination or crop cycle which has been imposed on Punjab, particularly paddy, only to fulfill the targets of central food or food grains.
Yes.
So now we will be going for paddy. Apart from your recommendation, if you go for anything for maize, we would not be able to control white fly. That is not my movement. That is the movement of agriculture scientists.
We can say that up to some extent this factor can be responsible, because when we go on paddy or over 38 lakh hectare, there are musty conditions. But especially, you know, when the spray of pesticide doesn't decrease on PT cotton, again, they are increasing, and there are two types of corporate sectors. One is the BT hybrids, and the second is of pesticide growth. And both